it was actually an unfortunate predicament for the homeowner. Her husband had passed away recently, and she decided she wanted to redo the kitchen. I don't know if it was just to have a fresh start or fresh take, or if it was just more of the kitchen was outdated and needed to have an update done to it, and it was just a step moving forward for her. It was more of just her kids were, I believe, getting towards that just ready to go away to college type of age, and it was just something she wanted to do for herself and the kids, just to give them that nice big roomy space that they could well use. It was kind of underutilized. The kitchen wasn't set up quite well when it was blocked off, and then you had that other room that it was large and they didn't really know what to do with it. She wanted to do something that opened up the space. She did have a peninsula or a return that blocked the kitchen off from an underutilized space. So that's kind of, it was kind of like a living room, but not really used like a living room space. So she wanted to open the kitchen up into that. And then she wanted to bring in some tall storage that she could use the lower section to store like a pantry type of situation, and then the upper to be more decorative. So those were probably her two main goals. So the island was something that we worked with her to create. She does have a soffit, and pretty much where that soffit ends is where her previous kitchen did end. And that's where that return came out and blocked off the kitchen from the space that they weren't really utilizing. So what we did was we opened it up, put in an island for her, and then she wanted to bring in multiple colors. So we did a nice fresh white in the back with a dark counter, and then we kept that counter the same color on the island and put in a darker island just to give it that unique pop or make it a focal point. So that was one of her requests. She wanted to make sure she had adequate seating for when she had guests over. The island has storage on all sides. So all four sides is accessible to storage, as well as she wanted seating on both sides. And it's quite a versatile piece. Don't really need a dining table anymore. She's got the island piece for just sit down with the family or to do entertaining. So we used our diamond cabinetry, and it is basically a shaker door style. It's their Montgomery door. And what we did was we did matching drawer faces as well, as opposed to a flat drawer face. So you have that shaker carrying throughout the whole kitchen. And then what we did on the back L shape of the kitchen, we went with a white paint. And then on the island and her tall pieces, we did the cherry with the thatch finish. And then we did the glass with glass shelves in the upper section of her tall cabinetry so she could display things and kind of make it feel not so kitcheny, more of like a display piece, but yet still using it as a kitchen piece. So we did replace her flooring, and we pretty much did it throughout the whole house. And it was a vinyl plank flooring, so it's that material that you don't have to really worry about, you don't really have to maintain, very durable, water resistant, waterproof type of material. So we had her work alongside with Pacific Appliance Group, and she went with KitchenAid Appliances. So they have that, they're not quite that commercial type of feel, but they do have those real commercial type of handles to them, but yet they still feel more residential. So she opted to go with the KitchenAid Appliances. So her bay window was existing. It was quite outdated. So we gave it a sprucing up, a facelift, if you would say, to the bay window area. And then what we did was we carried the same countertop surface as the decking of the bay area. So it's very durable. She's got plants up there. If they get overwatered and water should spill, it's not going to ruin the deck area of the bay window, because we did use the Cambria there as well. The soffit was probably our biggest challenge, because it goes from having the soffit over the kitchen space, which existing had been the end of the kitchen, and then opening up the space into an open beam type of situation. What we decided to do was to end the wall cabinetry at the end with the soffit. Originally, we had thought of bringing it out beyond that, but we thought it might look a little weird. So to help with that transition of the ceiling and then still incorporating the room as one, the soffit did pose a little bit of a challenge. I think she was really happy with how the island and the tall pieces came out the most. I think those were two of her her focal points within the remodel was having that tall piece, but not having it feel kitcheny, and then the island being a very usable, functional piece, with having the storage on all sides and seating on two sides.